What's up, y'all? It's Jeff. In this video, we're going to talk about defining scalar variables in MATLAB. Here again, we come back to the idea that programmers and mathematicians use and abuse the same words in different contexts. We've seen that in previous videos as something called overloading. In this case, the word variable is overloaded. In a mathematics context, we talk about variables as symbols representing unknown quantities. But in programming, the word variable has some very special meaning. I'm going to encourage you to think about variables in MATLAB as having three attributes, three features, three separate things going on. One of them is going to be a user-defined symbolic name. That is some name that we refer to the variables with. In MATLAB, there are some rules for defining those names, which we'll talk about in a different video. Every variable that we declare in MATLAB also has what we call an assigned value. That's the value that we're going to store in that variable. We're going to see what that means in just a minute. And then the last thing that variables have is something called a specific storage location or a memory address where we can find the value that's stored to represent that variable. Another thing to remember is that when we declare variables in MATLAB, when we set a variable equal to a value, we do so using the assignment operator. That is the equal sign in MATLAB. Again, we're abusing the equal sign because the programming use of the equal sign is very different than the mathematician's use of the equal sign. The whole idea of the assignment operator is on the left-hand side, we're going to type the symbolic name we want to call the variable. That's the one where MATLAB has some predefined rules on what we're allowed to use. On the right-hand side of the assignment operator, we're going to put something called either a numeric value or a computable expression, something where MATLAB will return some value. Now, of course, something called data classes in MATLAB mean that all variables don't necessarily have to be numeric. You can have characters, strings, many, many other types of variables. But for this introductory lesson, we're going to focus on scalar values or numeric variables. So the anatomy of a variable declaration, how we assign a variable a scalar value is, left-hand side, we declare some symbolic name. Right-hand side, we actually set that variable equal to our desired value, either numeric or computed. And then we put the assignment operator, the equal sign, in between that to tell MATLAB, hey, take this symbolic name and associated with that name, please store this value. Let's go ahead and store the variable x equals 9. We will not suppress the output. We'll just run that. What has happened here is MATLAB has now stored the value 9 in the variable x. But behind the scene, MATLAB has done much more than that. To actually get insights into what's happening behind the scene, we're going to use a little trick here. If we type the words format debug, we go ahead and hit enter, and then we hit the number x, which is an assigned variable, and push enter, notice MATLAB gives us some specific information. So the first thing MATLAB says is the structure address. Don't worry about that right now. Recognize that every MATLAB variable is actually a data structure, and this has to do with the fact that MATLAB, the base type of information that MATLAB stores is matrices. So this data structure has a lot more than just the three attributes that I said. It's more than just a symbolic name, an assigned value, and a memory address. It's actually a ton of information having to do with optimizing for matrix computations, but you don't have to worry about any of that. Remember, what we're thinking about is every variable stored in MATLAB has three major attributes that we're going to think about for this lesson. One of them is going to be a name. So the symbolic name that we define this variable with comes out first, x. The second one is going to be an assigned value. Here, x has value 9 based on our information that we stored here. And then the third is an address in memory. And here, MATLAB is telling us this is the hexadecimal code. You can think about this like an address. You know how houses have addresses? for the US Postal Service? Well, in your memory architecture, inside your computer, there's a bunch of basically voltages, high and low voltages, where you can store information. You either turn it on or turn it off. And the location of strings of voltages comes with addresses. So that if you think about your computer as the US Postal Service, your computer can tell, or MATLAB can tell your computer, hey, go run to this location where this information is stored and then get me that information. Well, this is a code, a special kind of encoding for the location where the actual value is stored in memory. This is going to be really interesting in just a minute, but I wanted to kind of peel back the layers behind what's happening when we declare a variable, so that when we say the word variable encoding MATLAB, we're not confused with what's happening in mathematics when we talk about variables. The final note that I'll make here is that these little pieces of information, M1, N1, this means that this is a 1x1 array, kind of a funny thing. We call that a scalar if we're kind of normal human beings. Later in life, we're gonna see that MATLAB actually, the standard data class is vectors and matrices. So it could be that M represents the number of rows, N represents the number of columns. It could be that there are 3 rows and 2 columns. That's a 3x2 matrix. This little PR, I believe that this is a pointer reference. And we're not gonna talk about pointers in this introductory class, but for those of you more advanced coders, there's some good documentation that you can find with a quick Google search about format debug and then how to reference pointers using MEX files. So to reiterate, when we type the command x gets 9 or x equals 9 into the command window, MATLAB does a few different things. First, it allocates some memory. It sets aside a location of memory where we're going to store the value of 9 using a specific code. We'll talk about that when we get to data classes. That memory has an address associated with it so that when we as users need to refer to it, MATLAB can tell the computer, go shag down the value that's stored in this particular address and then refer to it later. That's called a read operation. Finds the address associated with that memory and then writes the value of 9 using special types of encoding into that value. And that's what we're seeing here. This command, x gets 9 or x becomes 9, I'm going to encourage you to think about the assignment operator or read it as becomes or gets. What happens, we create a location in memory where we store the value of 9 for that variable. That's called a write operation. In other words, we're going to write in that memory location the value of 9. So the memory operation where we're taking a value and storing it in a variable is called a write. And then after we've done that writing, MATLAB internally is going to associate that memory location and its stored value with the user-defined symbol x. And that's super useful because when we then refer back to X in the future, MATLAB will automatically kind of fill in the blanks so that we can actually do math using that value. Referring back to X in the future is going to be known as a read operation. So a write operation takes some value and writes it into a memory location. A read operation goes to that memory location and collects the value stored in that location for a particular calculation. The reason that this is super useful is that it allows us to do some interesting things with variables that are kind of quote unquote illegal in mathematics, or at least have different meaning. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to something called format short. That's the default format for outputting variables. So up here, when I just declared x equal 9, this is called the short format. One of the really interesting things about thinking about each MATLAB variable as 3 different pieces of information, an assigned value, a user-defined symbolic name, and a memory location, is it allows us to write MATLAB code that takes this form. So x gets 4x minus 12. When I push enter on this, you're gonna see a result that is kind of non-intuitive if you have your mathematician's glasses on. Specifically, when I push enter, notice that the claim is that x is gonna be equal to 24. Let's analyze why that's true by thinking about each variable as having those three attributes. So specifically, when MATLAB reads the command, x becomes 4 times x minus 12 as a programming statement, the first thing MATLAB does is recognize the equal sign as an assignment operator. Remember previously we had this general pattern for how assignment operators work. On the left-hand side of the operator, we have a symbolic name, the one that MATLAB has special rules for. So the variable name in this case is x. Then we have the assignment operator in between. And on the right-hand side, we have a computable expression. So MATLAB recognizes I'm gonna be doing some work to write an output value from a computable expression into a variable named x. The next thing that MATLAB does is actually look at the right-hand side expression, the thing that it's going to compute, and kind of parse it based on the operations. Remember in a previous video, we talked about the idea of operator precedence. When MATLAB parses this, cuts it into pieces, it sees a multiplication operation and a subtraction operation. Multiplication has higher precedence than subtractions. In other words, we're gonna do the multiplication first. So MATLAB breaks that multiplication as the first object of focus and says, okay, I'm gonna multiply 4 times x. But x is a symbolic representation of a variable. MATLAB is now gonna go to the address in memory where x is stored and then get the value stored in that variable location so that it can do the multiplication with 4. That getting the value, going to read the value, is a memory operation that we're going to call reading. We have a value stored in x that was 9. It was stored at a particular location. The moment MATLAB sees this, it goes to the location, reads the value out, puts it into the multiply operation, and then it's going to multiply 4 times 9 because it has now read the value of that variable from memory. It will then compute 4 times 9 is 36 using some internal algorithm. Once we know that the first operation outputs 36, MATLAB moves down in the precedence. So it goes, okay, I know this is 36. Let's look at the next operation downward. That operation is going to do subtraction, take the output of the first operation, subtract 12, 36 minus 12 is 24. And now MATLAB has gotten the output of the computable expression on the right-hand side of my assignment operator. It's going to write that operation in the variable named x. So we're going to take the output and use the assignment operator to write it into that variable. Remember, we're thinking about each variable as having three attributes, a symbolic name, an assigned value, and a storage location. So in this situation, the symbolic name doesn't change, and we're gonna investigate whether or not the storage location changed, but now instead of the symbolic name having 9 associated with it, we are now gonna write over, we're gonna take that value and say, no, from now on, x is not associated with 9, it's associated with 24. With that in mind, let's go ahead and start with a brand new clean workstation. I just shut down MATLAB and restarted it. And then I'm gonna just go ahead and type in format debug to begin with. Now, let's go ahead and call the assignment operator and say x becomes 9. Here we go. We see that the symbolic name is x. The original structure address, the location where I can find more information about that variable x, is given by this address code that's in hexadecimal. Don't worry, we'll get there. And then the assigned value is 9. This is telling me a little bit more information. It is a 1x1 array. In other words, it's a scalar. This is a pointer, not gonna worry about that. But let's go ahead and recall the second operation, 4 times x minus 12. X becomes 4 times x minus 12. Notice MATLAB is gonna recognize this assignment operator, execute the computable expression on the right-hand side, and then store the output in the variable x. Our question is, we know that the symbolic name is gonna be the same, but does MATLAB now assign a new location, or does it overwrite the variable value in the same address? Let's go ahead and check. Notice in this situation, the address for the new value of x is not the same as the original address from this one. In other words, this variable assignment is actually getting written to a different address. In other words, even though the name of the variable is the same, the actual attributes underneath are different. That's a useful thing to know because it actually means this variable, when we read it, has different information than this variable than we write it. In terms of the sequence of operations, we do the computable expression that requires one memory operation, which is a read operation. Once we get that output, we write that, a different memory operation, to a new variable having a new address. I should say that from this point forward, anytime we refer to x, it's going to refer to the new location and the new value. So if I go format short, notice that x stored value is 24. No longer do I have access to the value of 9 that I had originally stored there. So when I refer to the write operation, from that point forward, the value of x is associated with the most recent write. That's a useful thing to kind of keep aware of. Let's do a quick recap, clearing the screen. Anytime we assign a variable, we're going to use the same anatomy. We're going to have the variable name. We could even call it name. And then we're going to have on the right-hand side some computable expression. Perhaps we say 2 to the 10 minus 32. In this case, when I push enter, three things happen. One of which is MATLAB stores the symbolic name that we chose. The second which is MATLAB will get a numeric value for the output of the computable expression and assign it with that variable name that will be associated. That is done inside computer memory, and there's also an address associated with that. Every time we declare a variable, follows the same anatomy. Left-hand side is variable name, then the equal sign, then a numeric value or computable expression. Every variable in this lesson, we're going to think about having a symbolic name, an assigned value, and also a memory address. All right, that ends this lesson on assigning scalar values to MATLAB variables. In a future lesson, we're going to talk about the rules for naming these variables and also keywords that are reserved, aka that we cannot use when we name variables. I'll see you in that next video.